If you're like one of my friends who just hate using the pen tool, or you don't want to use it even if you know how to use it, well, buddy, I've got good news for you. And the good news is, you don't have to. Yes, there's a particular extent to which we can make it automatic. If you want to create a path, you don't have to start by using the pen tool. However, a basic knowledge of how the pen tool works, how to work the handles and the points, it's going to be really helpful. And you can refer this video for that. But for now, without any further ado, let's get started. So here we are back in the magical world of Photoshop, and you would agree that there are a lot of ways to create automatic selections in Photoshop. However, here's the trick. You can turn those automatic selections to a path, resulting in creating an automatic path to begin with. Yes, we can do that easily in Photoshop. So here we have a bulb. So let's say you want to create a path around the bulb. Let's start by making a selection. And as you can see, it really is contrasting with that of the background, and definitely we can use the quick selection tool here. So click on the quick selection tool right there and just paint. Easily we have made a selection. Now, if you want to add some additional areas, of course, you can paint on that as well, just like so. If you want to quickly add a particular area, you can also use the lasso tool or the polygonal lasso tool. I'm just going to choose the lasso tool, and you can hold the shift key and make a selection to add, just like that. And you can hold the alt key or the option key to subtract a particular area. So I'm just going to add this area as well, just a tad bit. Now we have basic selection. It isn't amazing, but it's something to begin with, right? Now here's the trick. If you want to create a path around it using this selection, you can just right click on this and choose make work path. That's it. Now, tolerance here is very important. If the tolerance is very high, let's say 10 is the maximum, it's going to be very smooth with the least amount of anchor points. So if I set it to 10 and hit OK, see how smooth that is? It's not accurate at all. So we need to find that balance where it's not so smooth and not too harsh so that it goes too bumpy. So let me show that to you again. So if we go back, if we choose a very low tolerance by right clicking on it and then choosing make work path, and we choose 1 pixel, have a look at that. It's kind of too much. It just doesn't look right. However, these areas might look right because the edges already have a lot of bumps, but look at the top. Even though it is a smooth curve, it's making a lot of bump in here. So we need to find the right balance. So right click on it and choose make work path. And for me, let's go for 3. 3 seems to be nice. 3 is okay. It's reasonable. We have to adjust it a little bit. How about we go 2? Let's go back again, right click on it, make work path, and 2, hit okay. 2 is perfect. Perfect for this one. We can always adjust this later. Now, once we have created this path, keep in mind this is a work path. Maybe you took the pen tool and started making some more paths here and there. This can get removed. So to save a path, we need to rename it. So let's go to the paths tab. If you cannot see the paths tab, go to window and then make sure paths is checked. Now this is a work path. We need to name it. So double click on the text and name it bulb, or whatever you want to name it as. All right. Now the path is created just for this bulb. Now we can adjust it as much as we like. So now here comes the important part. You need to learn how to use the handles and the points. That is essential just to adjust it, right? So let's zoom in and try to adjust it right here. So you can always hold by using the move tool. First of all, once the move tool is selected, you can hold the control or command and click on that point which you want to edit. Just make sure not all the points are selected. If that point is blue, it means that point and that only point is selected. You can adjust it the way you want it. Now, if you want to adjust the handles or create new handles, you can always get back to the pen tool. So if you go back to the pen tool, and then if you hold the alt key and hover over it, have a look, an arrow shows up. You can click and drag to create a handle right there, which results into a curve. I can adjust it the way you want it by holding the control or command. So if you hold the control or command, you can adjust it, adjust all the points here and there, adjust it to your liking. And if you want to create new handles, hold the alt key, click and drag in the direction of the path, and this will be all right. So that's how you adjust it. I'm not going to do the entire thing, but you get the point. So this is something rough to get started with very nicely. You don't have to create the path from the scratch. Now you can use this feature in whatever way you desire. Maybe turn that into a vector mask. Maybe use that for a smooth selection. Or maybe use it for clipping path. Now, what is clipping path? Watch this video. It's very useful in printing purposes. Anyway, so I'm going to show you how to create a vector mask out of this. Let's get back to layers. Once this layer is selected, you can always go to layer, vector mask, and then current path, the path that is now selected. And there you have it, a vector mask. It's going to be always so smooth, no matter how big or small you make the bulb. Now, a simple mask is a raster graphic. Anything vector is based upon mathematics. So no matter how big you make it or how small you make it, and again, no matter how big you make it, it's never going to pixelate. The mask is never going to pixelate. So for this, we need to make sure just the layer is selected. Just unselect the mask and then press Ctrl or Command T. You can make it bigger, no matter as big as you want. I'm so sorry about that. All right. Now, have a look at the edge. Even though the bulb has started to pixelate, the edge, the mask is so smooth. Anyway, so you can use it in whatever way you wish. So I'm just going to select the image, not the mask. And let's move it to the middle. Let's make it a little bigger. You can change the background, do all kinds of fun stuff. Let's create a solid color adjustment layer. And we're going to choose a pink background, something like this. Hit OK. Get it back and maybe create a shadow and create some fun stuff. So you get the idea how you can use it, turn that into a selection, turn that into a vector mask. I'm just going to add a simple drop shadow. You can actually move the drop shadow if you want to. Once you're in the layer styles dialog box, you can move the drop shadow right here and then just increase the size, decrease the opacity, and use the multiple drop shadow trick. So you can actually add one more drop shadow right there and move it a little closer and decrease the size a bit. Decrease the opacity, create one more, click on the plus right there, move it a little more closer, and then maybe increase the opacity a bit and decrease the size. So you can create multiple drop shadows to create super fun effects, write some text. But the point is, you don't have to start by creating a path from the scratch. You can just turn a selection to a path and have something to begin with. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thank you for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.